Good morning, everyone. I hope you're all well. Today's class is going to be stretching, but having ballet as the main focus. So we're going to really stretch out the turnout muscles, those hamstrings, work our way through the whole body. And it's going to be really nice and slow, and you can take everything at your pace. So if you're feeling a little stiff, you can modify as we go. So it's totally tailored to what you are feeling today.
So we're going to take two shoulder rolls back. Two. We're going to tuck the chin, roll down through the spine, plie at the bottom, and come back up. And back. And back. Tuck the chin. Plie, come back up. Good. And back. Back. Tuck the chin. Nice. Really allow the head to hang. Tuck the chin, allow your spine to really mobilize. Back, back. Tuck the chin, last few here. Keep breathing. So we're just getting that body moving. We're getting that spine working. And it should start to feel a little bit warmer in the room. This time we're gonna stay down. Hang here for a moment. Just allow the knees to be nice and pulled up. We're going to take a plie bend here. So we're bending from the hips. And we're going to straighten the legs. And again, bend and straighten. Allow the head to hang heavy. Forward, bend and straighten. Good. Squeeze and bend and straighten. Nice work, guys. Really allow your lower, bend, and straighten. If you can, imagine your head is staying at the same level. Hanging low. You should feel the stretch along the backs of your calves and maybe even through the hamstrings slightly. This time we're going to take a plie, come to a rise. Plie, and rise. Good, and the same applies here. Keep that fold from the hips nice and close to your thighs. Good. So stomach is hanging down towards the thighs. Head is hanging down towards the floor. Good. Nice work, guys. Last one here. And we're just gonna go again to our You should feel even warmer now, so you might notice that you can hang a little bit lower. Good, keep breathing. Nice work, guys. Nice, last two here. And we're gonna take it back to a rise. Plie. And rise, to your highest demi point. And rise, good. Plie. And rise. Plie. And rise, good. We're now going to lower the heel. We're going to pad the hands out right in front of us until we reach our downward dog position. And we're just going to take a minute to hold here. Start padding through the feet, drawing the heels down towards the floor. We're thinking ribs in, and we're thinking sit bones to the ceiling. So try not to have your sit bones underneath you. Try push and open them to the ceiling. Good. Last few pads of the feet here. We're then going to take a rise and plie. Heels to the floor. Rise. Heels to the floor. Rise. Heels to the floor. You should really feel this in your calves and the backs of your legs. Good. Last few here. Two more. And down, last one. We're gonna go back to our padding of our feet. One more time. We pad. Two, three, four, nice. Five, six, seven, eight. And rise. Heels to the floor. Rise. Good work, guys. Your body should start to feel a lot warmer now. Three, two, We're now going to take the weight into our left leg and we're going to reach away with our right leg towards the ceiling. We should feel a lovely stretch through the legs, including the standing leg. Hold it here. Allow your body to sit in the position, breathing nice and deep. And breathe. Good. Now we're going to take a bend of this top leg into an attitude and we're going to straighten and flex that foot. Nice work, guys. And point and bend. Flex and straighten. Good. Point and bend. Flex and straighten. Four more. And straighten. Bend. Straighten. Last one. Straighten. Bringing that knee into the chest, step it out to a lunge. Nice. So we're making a nice long spine and low to the floor. So we're allowing gravity to do its work. So just take a moment here to breathe nice and deep and feel that feeling of the hips opening in that hip socket. And breathe. We're going to take a reach of that right hand towards the ceiling. So we're thinking shoulders are opening, hips are staying where they are. This deepens that stretch slightly. Good. Breathing nice and deep. Thinking 90 degrees with that front leg and straight back leg. Arms going to come down to the floor. We're going to take the weight into the hands and walk that foot across, lower into our pigeon pose. So this is a great one for that turnout muscles on the right leg. So the more you angle the leg, the deeper the stretch, and the closer you have that foot to you, the less the stretch. So find what's comfortable for you. And if you're feeling really, really loose, you can take that body down over the leg and just melt into the floor. Deep breaths. Well done, guys. Reimagine those muscles that are tensing, melting into the floor. Consciously tell them to relax. Breathing in, exhale. Last few breaths here. Breathing in, exhale out. And coming up, taking your hands either side of the mat again, tucking that toe in at the back, we're going to push back into our downward dog again. And we're just going to take a minute here to pad the heels for a second, and we're going to go to the second side. Take that left leg to the side, stretching those legs apart. Good. Consciously think of that pushing back into that leg, so you're not allowing your body to pushing back all the time. Good, hold it here. And we're gonna bend the toe, attitude, and flex and straighten. Good, bend and point. Flex and straighten. Bend and point. Good. Flex and straighten, bend and point. Last few here. We go last two and last one. Nice. Taking that knee into the chest, stepping forward into our forward lunge on the left side. So again, we're taking a 90 degree angle with this front leg and a straight back leg. Nice. And breathe. Really allow that pelvis to hang low here, guys. And then when you're ready, taking the weight into your right hand, we're going to reach that left hand up to the ceiling, twisting the shoulders and keeping the hips nice and low. Breathe nice and deep. Think about how heavy your pelvis is. Allow it to hang down towards the floor. Breaths. Exhale. Well done, guys, you're doing really, really well. Taking that hand back to the floor. gently, taking the weight into the hands. And we're gonna walk that foot across, lowering into our pigeon pose on the second side. So again, adjust accordingly to your body and relax into the stretch, whatever way feels best for you. And really think about those muscles. They might be tighter on one side than the other. This means that maybe you need to focus a bit more time on the side that's tighter. And last two breaths. Nice, coming up, taking that weight back into the hands. We're just gonna push back to a tabletop position. So this is where we take our hands directly beneath our shoulders and our knees directly beneath our hips. We're making sure that we're not locking into those arms and we're slightly bending them to protect the joints. Really good, guys. And we're gonna take a cat stretch. So we're gonna bend the spine up towards the ceiling. We're looking towards the belly button and then go the other way, arching the back, looking towards the ceiling and really, really allowing the spine to curve upwards. And again, well done, guys. Other way. So this should feel really, really nice in your back. And we're getting it moving. Other way. And back. Nice. We're now going to curve going to the right. So we're taking a little circle of the spine, going through each movement. But this time we're just going in a circle. Nice. We're gonna stop at the top, go the other way. Last two. Nice. Well done, guys. We're now going to just ripple forward, take a little step back with the knees. We're going to ripple forward to lie down on our front. So we're going to move to our next back stretch exercise. We're going to take the hands in line with the shoulders. So not too forward and not too back. We will move them in a moment depending on the level of the stretch that we're doing. And we're just going to take a little bend of the upper back. So these three sections of our back that we're stretching are upper back, our middle, and our lower. So we're gonna start with the upper, and this is where that lovely upper back bend we use in Portobello comes in our back bends. So we're going to take, just pushing into the hands slightly, not too far up. So really think about using the top of the spine here. And you should feel a slight stretch in that upper back. Making sure that your core is still active and you're not just completely relaxing to the floor. You're still pulling that belly button gently towards the spine. Good, coming back down. Taking the hands slightly forward, allowing the ribs to stay on the ground. We're gonna push a little bit deeper this time. Good, breathing deep. And come back down. This time we're gonna extend the hands in front of us. And we're going to push into that back. This should give you a little bit of a deeper stretch in that spine. If this is too much for you, stay in the first phase of the stretch. Nice. So you should just feel it around where your shoulder blades are. If you feel any pain, pull out of the stretch. That's not what we're feeling. Just a nice, gentle stretch. Good. Lower the body back down. We're going to now push into the middle section of the back. So we're coming slightly further up. So you should feel this a bit more in the kind of rib area. So we're really, really pushing down towards the ground with our spine. And we're trying to get that middle section moving a bit more. Deep breaths here. Lower down. Pushing back up again. Nice. Deep breaths. Good. gentle in this stretch. If anything doesn't feel good, pull out of it. So we're going to push up, keeping the hips on the floor. We're going to push back into that lower back. Nice and gentle here. Listening to your body. If it's saying no today, we'll all have days where we feel really loose and days where we feel a little stiffer. So just take it at your pace. Exhale. Inhale. Good, we're just gonna bend down. Take a moment, allow that spine to relax. And we're gonna go one more time. Well done. Nice work, guys. Breathing in, exhale out. And coming back. Good job, guys. We're going to push back into child's pose. So coming up and over those knees. And allow that spine to stretch out even more. So we're thinking the hands are reaching away from the body as much as possible. We're thinking elongating that spine and stretching it out vertebrae by vertebrae. Next, we're going to take the hands and we're going to just walk them towards the left. So we're just having a little increase of stretch on the right side of the body now. Imagine you're melting into the floor. Deep breath. And walking back to the center. Good. And walking to angle yourself to the right, stretching out that left side a little bit deeper. Nice. And coming back to the center. So finally, a stretch out here. Taking chest towards the floor. Nice work, guys. We're pushing back up. We're going to just lie down on our backs here. So take a moment to find your back. So we're not pushing that spine into the floor completely flat. We're leaving a little room for the natural curve of your spine and with your pelvis as well. Just find your neutral pelvic position on the floor. So we're not rotating it forward or tucking it under. It's nice and level for your body. And we're going to bend the knees up so the soles of the feet are flat on the floor. And we're going to grab a hold of our right knee. And now we're just going to take a little circle of that knee because we're going to take some overhead hamstring stretches next. So you want to make sure that the hip socket is nice and warmed up. So taking the circles a little bit bigger if you need. Listen to your body, what's feeling good, what's feeling stiff today in this hip. Nice. Breathing in. And last one, lower that foot to the floor. We're just going to take the second leg and we're going to do the same thing. So we're just mobilizing this joint and getting it nice and warm. Good. Well done, guys. You're doing really good. Now, lower that sole back down to the floor. We're going to take a piriformis stretch on our right leg to start. Bend that knee in towards your chest. We're going to grab hold of the sole of the foot with the left hand, the right foot with the left hand, and we're going to gently put a little bit of pressure on that knee of the right leg with our right hand. We're going to gently pull the leg from the center midline to just beyond. And you should feel this lovely stretch on the outside of the glute on the right side of the body. Very used muscle in ballet, and we need to stretch it out every day if we can. At least every day after a ballet class. So breathing deep here. You can take it a little bit deeper if you need. Good. Breathing through the stretch. And we're trying to keep the hips square, so we're not allowing the hips to go with the legs. Fighting We're next going to just take the leg to an extended position. I'm just grabbing hold of where it's comfortable for you for now. Bend that knee. Nice. And straighten that leg. Hold it here. And bend the knee. Straighten the knee. Breathe here. Another little bend. So we're building up. We're getting the leg to stretch. We're getting this muscle nice and warm so we can deepen it in a moment. Bend. And if you can't hold it onto your foot, you can hold onto your shin. You can hold onto your calf. Avoid holding onto the back of the knee. A bit of a dangerous area to hold onto. Or you can take a hand to the back of the thigh and to the back of the calf. So wherever is comfortable for you today, it'll differ day to day because we all have those days where we can't quite get our leg where we want. Hold it here, breathing nice and deeply. The more we relax, the easier the stretch will be. Bend that knee slightly. So try and think knee is coming to the right shoulder. And stretch. Well done, guys. And again, bend that knee to the shoulder. Stretch that toe to the ceiling. Really good. You should really feel this stretch in your hamstring. Make sure you're protecting your knee all the time so you're not awkwardly twisting the joint. Keep it nice and in line. We're then going to carry the leg to the side, coming to where our devil pay second. And we're just going to hold it here for a moment. Standing up in this position, this is your devil's head, and we're thinking, turn out that leg. Good. Last little push here. If you can, reach that toe towards your ear. Nice. We're then going to bend this toe down into a retire, returning both legs to our bent knee position. And we're gonna go the second side. So taking that knee, we're gonna come to a piriformis stretch. So taking a hold of that left foot with the right hand, away the knee with the left hand. Stretch. And we're gonna reach that toe across the body slightly. If you need to take your hand out just to give yourself a little bit more stability against that leg, feel free to. Nice. Really allow this stretch to target the outside of the glute on the left side. Nice. Well done, guys. Last few breaths here. Good. Bringing that leg in. Line it up again. We're going to stretch out that hamstring. So we're starting nice and small. Manageable stretches. So bend that toe. Bend that knee rather, stretch the toe. Straighten that leg. Bend the knee. So feel the muscle stretching, and rather than tensing up at that feeling, try and breathe through it. Try and relax. Tell the muscle. Just stay with it. Bend one more time and take that stretch a little bit deeper. We're going to extend the bottom leg away. And we're going to pull the leg towards the right, the left shoulder. So breathing deep. Bend that knee towards the left shoulder. Extend the leg. Well done. Bend the knee. shoulder here for a moment, trying to keep the hips square and the shoulders square as well. So holding onto this leg. Deep breaths. Well done, guys. And down into our retire. We're gonna come to a sitting up position next. So sitting high on our sit bones to try and not to have a curve of the spine, trying to sit high on the sit bones. If this is difficult, you can put some books underneath your bottom and it can lift you slightly. If not, hold it here. So we're sitting nice and tall and we're just gonna reach up to the sky and we're gonna take a little stretch down over the legs. So again, sitting high on those sit bones. And brush the hands back up again. We're going to think stomach to thigh, so we're rolling from the pelvis. So imagine there's someone behind you pushing your pelvis down towards the floor. Good. Good, nice work, guys. We're getting to the final section of the class. You're doing really, really well. And brushing back up. We're now going to just come to a standing position for a moment. And we're going to take the feet into a second position, into a wide second position. And we're just going to bend into a stretch. And we're going to prepare for our box flip section of the class next. Before we go to our box splits, we're just going to go to our front splits first. So stepping into a lunge, like so, we're going to hang this pelvis down towards the floor. We're going to lower the knee and push back into a hamstring stretch. Really, really feel the stretch nice and deep. Hips and the shoulders are staying completely square to the floor. So we're not twisting anything, it's nice and square. Pushing forward into that lunge. And come back. And we're gonna go one more time, and then we're gonna push back into our right leg front split. Pushing forwards. Nice. And coming back. Allow that chest to really hang down over that front leg. And we're now just going to walk that front leg forward, or that back leg back. We're gonna come into our splits. So keeping the hips as square as you can, allow the stretch to just happen. Breathe deep into it. If you can't get all the way down, of course, hold yourself up where you need to and just allow yourself to find that point of the stretch that you can breathe through. Don't push yourself beyond that point. Try and breathe and keep it comfortable. And if it doesn't feel good, pull out of the stretch and continue with our forward lunge and our stretch backs. We're then gonna come down over the leg if you can. Stretching forward. We're gonna come back up, take a little walk back. And again, forward over the leg. Coming up. We're then going to take the left hand to the right leg and our right hand to the left leg. And we're just going to take a little twist of the body. So we're rotating the spine to look towards the leg that is in front. Nice. Last few breaths here, guys. Stay with it. And gently uncurl the body. And we're going to come out of the split, taking it to the second side. So we're coming into that forward lunge. Good. Allow that pelvis to hang down towards the floor, and we're gonna push over that leg. You might have one leg that's way better than the other. That's quite normal. So that means you just need to focus on that other side just a little bit more. Good. Pushing back. Really hang down over the leg. And again, try and keep that spine as long as you can. Hang down over that leg. And we're gonna come into our splits. So shooting the legs apart from each other. Good. Hold it here for a moment. I'd love to know, are you a right leg or a left leg splitter? Let me know after the class. Be really interested to know. And we're going to come down over that leg. Deep breaths here. And coming up, little walk back into the back bend. Come down over that leg again. And coming back up. We're going to take the right hand to the left leg and our left hand to the right leg, twisting away from that front leg, or towards the front leg rather. We're nearly there, guys. You're doing so, so well. Nice. Last breath here. Uncurl the spine and gently come out of that stretch in your own time. We're going to come to our second stretch again. And we're going to open up those hips. Just take a moment here and we're going to come down into our side lunge. Like so. So we're keeping this leg nice and turned out. The sole of the foot is flat on the floor, arch is lifted, so we're not rolling. We're keeping it all nice and placed. Coming from the second side. Good. Nice. And we're just gonna take a moment now to come down into our box. If you can't come into a flat box, just keep your legs slightly in front of you. Lovely. So now we're in our box splits. We're going to take the arms up to second. And we're going to reach over with our right arm to our left side. And we're thinking the side of our body, the left side of our body is coming to the left leg. So come down over it. Lovely. And stretch it out here for a moment. We're trying to keep the hips sat on the floor still, so don't allow this hip to lift if you can. If you are lifting it, come up a little bit. Good. Last few breaths here. And coming up. We're going to reach over to the second side. Reach over. And again, we're thinking that side of the body is coming to the leg that we're stretching on. Really good work, guys. Really allow the stretch to be felt on this side. And we're keeping this top shoulder nice and open. We're not dropping it forward. Think of opening the chest to the ceiling. Good. Coming up. And we're just going to gently walk our hands forward, coming a little bit deeper onto that stretch. And keeping the toes lifted and flexed, we're just going to roll forward if you can into our box. So don't allow the legs to collapse. Forward, keep them nice and turned out. And just take a minute here to stretch. Nice, guys. Pushing back nice and gently. Bringing the legs together, well done. Give them a little bit of a shake out. We're now going to come to standing and we're going to take a wall stretch. So if you don't have a wall, you can just come back to the front splits on the ground and lie down over that front leg. But if you have a wall, like myself, you're going to take your back facing the wall, you're going to take your hands to the floor, and we're going to reach that right leg up behind us along the wall. And we're just going to allow ourselves to just pull up nice and high on this supporting leg. And the further we can get our foot towards the wall, the deeper the stretch will be on that supporting leg. And we're just thinking of pushing the hips towards the wall. Nice. And we're gonna bring down that leg and come up with the other leg. Well done, guys, you're doing so well. So hips are to the wall. here. And coming down. Lovely. And we're just going to come to standing and we're going to finish with a lovely eye stand of the leg. So we're just going to take our right leg into our right hand, grab a hold of that foot, stretch up to the ceiling, and stretch it into our second. Lovely. Nice. Really good. And you can take a few little bends into the stretch a little bit further if you want. Or if you're feeling really good, you can grab hold of that foot with the other arm just to increase the stretch slightly. Nice. Good. And coming down, we're going to go the second side. Reach that leg up over your head. Good. And take a few deeper stretches. Nice. So we're pulling nice and pulled up, so we're not allowing our body to collapse. We're keeping this side of the body nice and straight here. Grabbing hold of the other hand. Nice, guys, you're doing really, really well. And bring that down. And we're just going to come back to sitting. Take the feet to a frog position and just allow the knees to hang down towards the floor. Sitting high in our sit bones, closing the eyes. Take a deep breath, exhale. Take another deep breath in. Exhale here, last time. Exhale here. And then open your eyes. Well done, guys.